गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट माय लेक्चर ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ रेडिएशन पैटर्न ऑफ टू आइसोट्रॉपिक पॉइंट सोर्सेज ऑफ इक्वल एम्पलीट्यूड एंड सेम फेज. First of all, the question arises, what is radiation pattern? As we all know that radiation pattern is one of the important characteristic of an antenna toward deciding its various properties. So our topic is radiation pattern of two isotropic point sources. Isotropic means ideal antenna, and point source means that we have taken antenna as a volumeless radiator. So we can start now. Here we have taken two point sources, point 1 and point 2. Point 1 and point 2 basically indicates the antenna. They are separated by a distance d. We have taken a reference line for drawing the radiation pattern as 0. So this is the reference line. We have to draw the radiation pattern at the distant point P. Because as we all know, we draw the radiation pattern at the far field region. So the reference point is 0. So with the distance between 1 and 0 is d by 2, and 0 and 2 is d by 2. We have taken reference line as this. So now we have taken the image of 1 as 1 dash on the reference line, and image of 2 as 2 dash on the reference line. So now the path difference becomes 1 dash and 2 dash between the two isotropic point sources. So this is equal to d by 2 cos theta. So our path difference equal to 1 dash 2 dash, and this is equal to d by 2 cos theta plus d by 2 cos theta in meters. So the resultant is d cos theta in meters. But when we convert it in wavelength, this will get divided by the wavelength. This is equal to d by lambda cos theta. Here the unit becomes wavelength. From the optics, we know that phase angle is equal to 2 pi into path difference. So we have taken this condition. Phase angle psi should be equal to 2 pi into path difference. We have already calculated the path difference, which is equal to d by lambda cos theta. So we have multiplied it by 2 pi to get the phase angle. So where our phase angle becomes 2 pi into d by lambda cos theta, and the unit here is radian. But as we all know that beta is equal to 2 pi by lambda, where beta is the phase shift. So our phase angle psi becomes beta d cos theta, and the unit is again radian. As we all know that we draw the radiation pattern in two ways. One is the electric field pattern and another is the power pattern. Here we are going to draw the radiation pattern on the basis of the field pattern, that is electric field pattern. Now the electric field due to source 1 at the distance point 2, that is the far field region, is given by E1. Similarly, electric field due to source 2 at the far field region at the distant point P, where we have to draw our radiation pattern, is given by E2. And the total field due to superposition of electric field due to source 1 and source 2 is given by the E, and this is equal to total field due to source 1 and source 2. Here we have to superimpose the field due to source 1 and source 2 to get the total field AE. So we have to add on. Now the question arises, why I have taken this as the minus and this as the plus? So the reason is, as we all know that waves from source 1 will reach the distant point P at the latter time as compared to waves from source 2. That means that waves from source 1 will lag and waves from source 2 will lead to reach the distant point P. So waves due to source 1 will have a lag, and waves due to source 2 has a lead. That's why we have taken here minus and here plus. So our field becomes this. We have to solve this equation. We have multiplied it with 2 and divided by 2. Our equation is this. As we all know, e to the power minus j psi by 2 plus e to the power plus j psi by 2 divided by 2 is given by cos psi by 2. So we have replaced this complete equation with cos psi by 2. Now our equation become E is equal to 2E naught cos psi by 2. Here 2E naught is the amplitude, and as we all know that, as we have already derived that psi is beta d cos theta by 2. So I have replaced psi with beta d cos theta by 2. So in this equation 2E naught is our amplitude and cos beta d cos theta by 2 is our phase. Now for drawing the radiation pattern for an ideal condition, we have to normalize this equation. For normalizing this equation, I have substituted 2E naught equal to 1. So our equation becomes E should be equal to cos b d cos theta by 2. As beta is 2 pi by lambda, we have, let us assume, d is equal to lambda by 2. So in the place of d, I have substituted lambda by 2 and cos theta by 2. So lambda cancel out. 2 and 2 get cancelled out. So our equation becomes E equal to cos pi by 2 cos theta. This is the normalized equation for drawing the radiation pattern. If we want to draw the radiation pattern of any arrays, we have to first find out the normalized equation, or in other words, we can call it as an array factor. For drawing the radiation pattern of an antenna, we draw basically require three things. First of all, direction of maxima. Second thing, direction of minima. And the third thing is the half power point direction. Half maxima means where the radiation has got the maximum major lobe. Minima means where the direction radiation, there is no radiation. Half power point basically means that where the power goes half. As we all know that power is proportional to E square. So we have the field equation in the form of electric field. So E should be equal to 1 by root 2, or we can say it is proportional to 1 by root 2. Now direction of maxima, our normalized equation is this. So for getting the direction of maxima, what would be the maximum value of any trigonometric equation? That will be of course equal to 1. So cos pi by 2 cos theta should be equal to plus minus 1. This means cos pi by 2 cos theta should be equal to plus minus n pi. N should be any value between, any integral value, 0, 1, 2, 3, any. But for the first condition, we have taken n equal to 0. So our equation becomes pi by 2 cos theta max should be equal to 0 by putting n equal to 0. Now pi by 2 cos theta max is equal to 0. This means cos theta max should be equal to 0. Then in which condition, at which value that cos theta should be equal to 0? That is of course 90 degree and 270 degree. So the direction of our maxima is 90 and 270 degree. Again, next we have to find out the direction of minima. At the point we have the null field. So equation should be written as cos pi by 2 cos theta should be equal to 0. And when we solve it, pi by 2 cos theta means should be equal to 2n plus 1 pi by 2. Again, we have taken the n equal to 0. So our equation become pi by 2 cos theta min pi plus minus pi by 2. Then cos theta min should be equal to plus minus 1. At which condition that cos theta should be equal to 1? Again, we can say that it is at 0 degree and 270 degree. So our direction of minima is 0 degree and 180 degree. Now again, the question of half power point direction. So I have already told you that E should be equal to 1 by under root 2. So in the equation of field, we have substituted plus minus 1 by under root 2. Now our equation becomes pi by 2 cos theta half power point direction 2n plus 1 pi by 4. On solving we get cos theta h half power point direction should be equal to plus minus half. Plus minus half we will get at 60 degree and 120 degree. So the basic parameter which are required for drawing the radiation pattern I have already calculated: direction of maxima, direction of minima and direction of half power point. Now we have taken a plot. Here this is a direction of 0 degree, 180 degree, 90 degree, 270, 60, minus 60, plus 20 and minus 20. So direction of, what should be the direction of maxima? Direction of maxima is 90 degree and 270 degree. That means direction of our major lobe should be this direction and this direction. Direction of our minima is 0 degree and 180 degree. That means this is the direction of null. We will do not get any radiation in this two direction. Now half power point direction is 60 degree and 180 degree. That means this is the point where the power get half of the radiation. So we have drawn the radiation pattern as major lobe in this direction cutting 60 degree and 180 degree in the upper region and similarly at the lower region. In this way we will get the radiation pattern of a two isotropic point sources with equal amplitude and same phase. So here we can see that we get the bidirectional donut shaped radiation pattern. This is the condition for a broadside array. In the next class we can discuss radiation pattern of a two isotropic point sources with equal amplitude and opposite phase. In that case we will see we get the infrared type of radiation pattern. Thank you.